why would we want an oral PCSK9 inhibitor? So as you know, the drugs have been highly effective, lowering LDL cholesterol, reducing events. We haven't seen very good uptake. And some of this may be due to access, some may be due to injections, but the hope would be is to develop. We see that most people are taking, for asymptomatic conditions, pills. And if you have another medication which is equally effective but easier to access, the hope is that this could help more people get their LDL to target. Yeah, so this is a phase two study, dose finding, and there were five groups. There were four different dosages, 6, 12, 18, 30 milligrams, and a placebo group. And it turns out that even at the first dose of 6 milligrams, 41% reduction. Once you got to 12 milligrams, you were really in the 50s. And at the top dose of 30 milligrams, it was a 61% reduction. So that is very consistent with what you get with an injectable monoclonal antibody hitting that 60% target. You know, this was a short-term study, basically looking at tolerability in terms of discontinuations. They were low. There was no evidence of any dose-dependent discontinuations of the therapy. Side effect profile looked very good. It was a short-term study, but basically this is the kind of information that looks to be very helpful for moving to the next part of a phase three program. You know, what's really interesting to me as an investigator is that I was told a decade ago it would be impossible to make a small molecule to inhibit PCSK9. It's a very difficult target. And this is kind of the marriage of biotechnology, screening cyclic, macrocyclic peptides, library of 10 to the 14th, hooked to a messenger RNA. They find a molecule that's at work well, and then it has remarkable medicinal chemistry to improve that. So it's really a tour de force, I think, of kind of a marriage of biotechnology with medicinal chemistry to come up with what was thought to be an undruggable oral pill. You know, I found it very interesting because, you know, we have in another area, you know, that there's GLP-1 agonism. The oral formulation is not as effective as the injections with it. It has efficacy, but it was just to me this improvement in terms of the technology to be able to screen macrocyclic peptides and be able to get, if you get them potent enough, even though you don't need it that much to be absorbed because they're so potent. So I find it fascinating. You know, we've seen the application. When you find a new target, fully human monoclonals, siRNAs, now macrocyclic peptides. So it's really exciting to see what's happened in the field of drug development. So one important aspect of the study was it was looking at a broad range of patients. So about 49% were women. And it turns out if you look at the group, you had 65% white, 40% Hispanic, 16% Asian, and it was a mixture of people with cardiovascular disease, 38%, high risk, a little over half, and some who are lower risk but with high LDLs. So the thought was, let's get a look at this and how it works in a broad group of people, some on statins, some not on statins, in terms of its efficacy. Well, based upon these very promising results, a phase three program is being designed.